A ticket to play for the NBA title awaits the winner. Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals on EA Sports. We're at Little Caesars Arena. Tonight, the Detroit Pistons taking on the Milwaukee Bucks. Alongside Jay Williams, I'm Ed Cohen. Jay, you look at the Pistons as they enter play. They have the home court here, always crucial in a Game 7, with the winner moving on to the NBA Finals.
Now look, I think both teams are worthy of going to the NBA Finals, but the reality is that only one team will prevail this evening. And the way this series has gone so far, I wouldn't be surprised if it goes all the way down to the final shot.
Fires the three, taken down by Giannis. Bledsoe with the basketball, looking to make something happen. To Lopez. With the fadeaway, burns him for the basket.
You feel that? I see the confidence building.
The possession in favor of Detroit. Jackson to Drummond. Probing the defense. Drummond to Griffin. Finger roll, finishing with finesse.
Old school equals high percentage.
Giannis in control of the basketball. Just getting started. Strap in for a good one here in Game 7. To Bledsoe. Pistons clear the board. Has a look. Griffin's shot won't go. Giannis with it up top. He'll run the offense. Oh, nice find for the basket.
Strong finish. That's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
Jackson with it. They trail by two. Here comes the screen. Got it to go on the step back. Jay, he found a way.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
No, I missed a short one there. To Jackson. Deep two there, won't go. To Bledsoe. To Middleton. Giannis for two. That's no good.
I got this clown. Let's go.
To Griffin. Oh, look out. Blake Griffin. 2 for 3 now here in the first.
There are certain guys in this league that should be put on alert status 24-7 because either they're posterizing you or that attempt can still be a poster.
Here comes the screen. And he's fouled. Very close, Jay. Free throws coming up.
Trust me, you want to avoid early foul trouble. Take that one as a warning.
Giannis Antetokounmpo at the line for two shots. A career 74% free throw shooter. Misses the first. No good on the first, no good on the second. 0 for 2. It's Detroit's ball. Ish Smith to Luke Kennard. Able to convert inside.
There you go, finally. Shoot your shot.
Giannis in control of the basketball. Down four. Short jumper misses. Kennard. And he'll go to the foul line.
Hey, look, sometimes you need to feel out your opponent. Let him know you're there. I'm okay with that early foul.
Thonmaker, a couple of free throws on the way. For his career, 68%. First try at the line, no good. So he goes 1 for 2 from the line after hitting on the second. Bledsoe with it up top, counting down towards 1 minute to play here in what's been a fast-moving opening quarter. Shot from the lane won't go. Shot by Smith, off the mark. Bledsoe with the basketball, down 5. To Adetokunbo. And they call the foul. Jay, he was there too late.
Here's the truth. As long as you're using your legs and your body to stay in front of the offensive player, you won't get called for those. You keep reaching, though, it's going to be a long night.
Can't connect on the first free throw. Good bounce back. Hits the second. It's a 1 of 2 trip. Pistons ball here. Ish Smith, defended by Connaughton. To Luke Kennard. Scores from the post.
That's a good run right here to end the first quarter to open up that lead. If you're the coach of this team, you have to like the effort your guys are giving.
Screen coming. Giannis shoots. Collected by Drummond. He'll let one fly from half court. 1 quarter down in this deciding game 7. We're back with more after this. You're watching the Eastern Conference Finals on EA Sports. One quarter down. Neither side really distinguished itself. Jay, what stood out?
And when both teams are playing at this level, it just continues to reaffirm that I was excited to watch both of these teams play this entire week. It's been a solid game so far, but this has a chance to be a great one down the stretch.
To George Hill. Trying to cash in. Round shot, no good.
That's how you do it. You keep riding him to the basket, and if the refs aren't calling it, keep being physical. Keep knocking him off balance.
Glenn Robinson III matched up with Connaughton. Griffin to Smith. Short jumper stays out.
And it's never a great thing when you're talking to yourself the entire next possession about the shot you just missed. Now you know you're in that player's head mentally.
To Hill. 5 on the shot clock for Milwaukee. Has a chance. Not that time.
I'm here.
I got ball. Ish Smith. From the painted area, won't go down. Hill across the timeline, down 6. Nice pass to set things up.
Woo, did you see that? Eyes to the rim, and the rest was all net.
Pistons have it to Luke Kennard.
Run.
Ish Smith, down to Griffin.
It's because he took his eye off his target, Ed. As an offensive player, you have to glare at where the defender's coming to, but quickly redirect yourself to your actual target. He was more consumed with the defender than he was the actual rim.
Old school, backs his man down for the basket. Whistle stops play, and we'll get a timeout here for Detroit as they'll make sure they're aligned here in a two-point basketball game. Mixing things up. Hockey line substitutions. Both teams making changes.
I'm on D.
To Griffin.
Yep.
Around the perimeter.
Yep.
Kennard.
Put a roll.
To Smith.
Wait on it.
Good look that time, but off the mark. Another follow stays out. Another follow, still no good. To Adetokunbo. Ish Smith. To Luke Kennard. To Smith.
Yep. Roll. Hey.
Wait on.
Watch the slip.
From long range, Luke Kennard bothered just enough on that one. To Lopez. Brook Lopez. He is shooting well. He's made two-thirds of his shots.
Man, that may not have been a gimme, but that layup at the rim definitely chips away at the pride of the defense.
I got ball. Pick up. Match up.
To Smith.
Run.
Screen coming.
Come on, you gotta work around the screen. You're killing me.
Yep.
A drive, but he can't get it to go. To George
Defense.
Hill.
Yep.
Defense, let's go.
Put a roll.
Hey. Wait on it.
And he's fouled. Couple of free throws coming up, Jay.
Love the fact that the shooter created contact on the upward motion to shoot the basketball. Big time play.
Giannis Antetokounmpo. He's got two shots coming. He's struggled so far. First free throw is good. And fails to hit them both. Hits the first, misses the second. Right now, the Pistons have the basketball. To Smith. Missed it. Almost a foul. They let it go. And scores, plus the foul. You have to respect every part of his game. Blake Griffin going to the line for a chance at three. Blake Griffin trying to cash in on the three-point play. For his career, 68%. And he can't convert the free throw. Bledsoe with it up top. It's a one-point game, 13-12. Hill, not that time, he misses. Has a look. Can't connect.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down. He took it out on the rim that time.
Oh, there's no better feeling than after throwing that one down, hanging on the rim a little bit, looking at your opponent beneath you, making him recognize that's where you'll be the entire ball game.
Here comes the screen. Ish Smith to Drummond. Beyond the arc for three. No good. That's great defense.
Shooter, shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
We are at halftime in Game 7. Let's get you to Orlando, where we say hello to Jalen Rose and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Jalen.
Thanks, Ed. The Bucks have the lead, but not by much. And while they do have an advantage on the scoreboard, you can be sure they like to grow their lead. They've been putting in the kind of effort that can lead to a positive outcome, which is, of course, a win. These are the guys getting buckets
for the Milwaukee Bucks.
The Pistons aren't down by too much at the half. They certainly staked the flag in the paint. They were dominant around the rim on the offensive end. These are the guys getting buckets
for the Detroit Pistons.
Game track. Missed threes.
There was a point in the opening half where I was starting to get confused by all of the three-pointers. Now, don't get me wrong, the three could be a great part of any team's game. But if you're missing a lot of threes, why are you forcing the issue?
Player of the half.
Ate Tecumpo put in the hard work that's needed to grab all of those rebounds. He was a rock for his team.
Who was cold?
No one was to be picked for this segment, but he couldn't avoid it. Maybe he'll turn things around in the second half. Here's our top plays from the first half.
Number two. Number one.
Thanks for joining us for the halftime report. The second half is about to get started.
Bucks basketball.
It's my man right here. Y'all get yours. I got ball.
Adetokounmpo to Lopez. Brook Lopez, looking good, 4 for 5.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed. It's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket.
To Griffin, Ish Smith. The shot, almost.
I got ball.
To Adetokounmpo. Andre Drummond sends it away.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
Gets it in the right corner. To Griffin. able to convert inside.
Ooh, shows like this separate the good players from the great ones. The good players, they have good first halves, and then they fade to black in the second. The great players, they just sustain that kind of dynamic energy throughout the entire ball game.
Adetokunbo. Shot clock's at 5. Down to 4. Giannis Adetokunbo. Rebound taken down by the Pistons. Here comes the screen. Ish Smith. To Griffin. Works it. Trying to cash in. Oh, look out. Blake Griffin. He's now 5 for 6. Simply put, can you build a franchise around Blake Griffin right now?
No, not right now. I think he's starting to get to the latter part of his career. I think he could be a key cog in a championship team, but just not the main guy.
Followed up, Brook Lopez with the slam.
You see, Ed, that's the advantage of growing up playing with and against a twin. A lot of fights, a lot of physicality, and controlling the glass is everything.
The possession in favor of Detroit. Wait on it. Ish Smith. Shot clock to 4 for the Pistons. Has a chance. Deep 2 there. Won't go.
It's easy. Force guys into low percentage shots. That's the reason why we're big into stats. It was all provided to you before the game in the scouting report.
It's good. That's the guy you want to leave open.
Man, he's got the defender out there tap dancing like that on national TV. That's not a good sign.
The big fella, Andre Drummond. Tough shooting. Only 2 for 6 after that make.
And if you don't contest, he's knocking that down with ease.
Adetokunbo to Lopez. Nearly got that one to go. Griffin driving, but his shot won't go down. Giannis with it up top. Leads just a point. To Middleton. Adetokunbo. To Middleton. 4-3. He might be underrated, but Chris Middleton, the defense was ready, still knocks it down.
Yeah, and what we're seeing is a brilliant offensive display. You have ball movement, player movement, and great shooting to top it off. You get those three things going, you're going to be a dynamic offensive unit.
Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here comes some changes. Ish Smith matched up with Connaughton to Drummond. Jackson to Drummond. Short jumper off the mark. Hill into the front court. Leads 4. Giannis for 2. And it's Griffin there to clear the rebound. Jackson with it. Looking to make something happen. to Griffin. Knock loose. Bucks have it. Adetokunbo knocks it down from mid-range.
Yes, sir.
Desperation shot here from half court. That ends the third quarter. The Bucks with the lead. Pistons basketball here to start the fourth quarter. They trail to this point, but you'd have to say this one's up for grabs.
And the new style we play with in this league, all it takes is three quick threes and you're right back in the ball game.
The big fella, Andre Drummond. Oh, 3 for 8, he's gotta do better.
Woo, did you see that? Eyes to the rim and the rest was all net.
Bledsoe to Adetokunbo. Old school. Backs his man down for the basket. It's Detroit's ball. Ish Smith to Griffin. Detroit with 4 to shoot. To the basket goes Jackson, but a shot won't fall.
And one of the most underrated things in this game is quick lateral speed. Good job by utilizing that speed and taking away the lane.
Gets it to go, and the foul.
So many times we get on a defender for quote-unquote letting the offensive player score on an and one. Sometimes there's a lucky bounce, but more often than not, it's the offensive player who makes the play happen despite the defender's best intentions.
George Hill at the line for a chance at a 3-point play. For his career, 80% at the line. And he missed the free throw. Here comes the screen. And a putback slam.
Woo, that's nasty right there.
Bucks at the controls. To Bledsoe. George Hill takes stock of the floor. He's going to the free throw line to shoot.
This drives me nuts when I see fouls like that being called in a close game. Sometimes you just gotta let them play, ref.
Giannis Adetokunbo at the line for 2 shots. He struggled so far, and he connects on the first free throw. Two for two on that trip.
Good money. Yep.
Clown for you.
What a roll.
Hey. Wait on it.
Go. So, I got the right here. Stop.
To Griffin.
Hey. What's going on?
With the fadeaway, burns him for the basket.
And there's nothing more mentally intimidating for your opponent than when your own teammates are unselfish and make sure that you get the ball because they want you to drop 70 on them, maybe like Devin Booker did last year.
Middleton to Adetokunbo. Plenty of contact. The shot, no good.
Yo, big kudos to the defender. It seems like his mere presence in the paint was enough to make the offensive player miss the shot before he even got off the ground.
The big fella, Andre Drummond. He's 5 for 10, shooting 50%.
Oh, he buckled his knees so bad, it didn't matter if he scored or not. That's a win for the internet.
Adetokunbo to Bledsoe. Blake Griffin snatching it out of the air. Out of bounds, last touch by the Pistons. Looks like some substitutions are coming on in. Bledsoe. Giannis in control of the basketball. They lead it, 4-point game. To Bledsoe. The Bucks with four to shoot. Middleton. Tough shot. Well defended.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Milwaukee with the basketball. Blake Griffin!
Oh! And he can't keep it in off the block.
Man, that was impressive. We have both squads set to make some moves right now. Bledsoe. Gets it in the left corner. Middleton. Here's Lopez. Down low. Rebounds claimed by Detroit.
I got ball.
To Griffin. Shot clock to four for the Pistons. Can't connect. Hill across the timeline. 2-point advantage. To Bledsoe. Fires the three. Cleans it up. On the follow. Way to stay with it.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays. No one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
To Griffin. Down to five on the 24. Going to launch beyond the arc. Knocks it down. That was a tough shot.
I mean, does he have eyes in the back of his head or what? I get paid money to watch and study this game daily. Even I didn't see that angle.
From the painted area, won't go down.
And you see so many players quit on a play after they were beat the first time, but not him. He stayed on his hip, he fought back, and he made the player miss the shot. That's great defense.
Ruling is there was intent. It's an intentional foul.
Too close to call right now. We're in clock management mode. That was a good play.
And here's an intentional foul. That's free throws. Clock stops with 13 seconds to play.
Ed, what's that old saying? Ruffled feathers do not flock together. Well, actually, I just made that up. But what it means is that play will cause a little havoc. As designed, the team that uses it to galvanize as a unit will have the advantage.
Able to convert on both free throws. Now the Pistons going to use a timeout. They're going to have to draw something up for an open look at a three. Has a look. Shot no good there for Griffin. And they'll get the intentional foul. So two free throws coming up, and you figure one out of two could be enough to seal the deal. Giannis Antetokounmpo, couple of free throws on the way. At this juncture, he's shooting 60% from the line. Knocks down the first. Goes two for two.
Oh yeah.
Late heave to beat the buzzer. The Bucks claim victory. They stand alone atop the Eastern Conference on their way to the NBA Finals. For my partner Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been the NBA Playoffs on EA Sports. Find out more at easports.com. Until next time, good night.
Here we go with the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Bucks have every reason to celebrate right now, but they know their job isn't done till they've made friends with that Larry O'Brien trophy. They'll be representing the East on their way to that goal. Check out the leading scores for the Milwaukee Bucks. The Pistons were eliminated from the playoffs today, and I'm sure there are no words that can make them feel better right now. Making the playoffs can be considered a success, but that's probably not what they want to hear right now. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored
for the Detroit Pistons.
Game track. Three-point shooting.
Each of these teams were solid with their long-range shooting. So by extension, they were pretty poor with their perimeter defense. Closing out on shooters must always happen, whether you're tired or not.
Player of the game.
Antetokounmpo could not have been more impressive in this game. The way he scored the basketball looked like he was playing with kids in high school.
Who was cold?
What can you say about a guy like this? Except that he fits the title of this segment. He was definitely cold in this game. Here are the top plays from the game.
Number two. Number one.